Prostate cancer is the second most common type of cancer found in men. And one of the tools that can help identify prostate cancer is known as a PSA test, which stands for a prostate-specific antigen test. So let's break down how that tool actually works. Now, PSA is a protein that's released by healthy prostate cells, as well as transformed or cancerous prostate cells. However, those cancerous prostate cells actually release a lot more PSA. So when looking at PSA levels, an increase in PSA could mean that someone has a higher chance of having prostate cancer. But when running a PSA test, the first thing that will be done is a blood sample will be taken. It will then be sent off for analysis, and what someone's going to look for is the amount of PSA that's found in the blood, measured in nanograms per milliliter. And they may do this several times over a period of time, and that's to look at the trend. Maybe PSA levels are staying steady, or maybe they are gradually increasing. And that may be indicative of prostate cancer, but higher levels of PSA could also mean that someone has an enlarged prostate or prostate inflammation. So in order to confirm if it is prostate cancer, there will be other steps that are taken, such as seeing if someone has other symptoms associated with this condition, as well as running a DRE or digital rectal exam. And then lastly would be taking a biopsy of the prostate to actually look at those cells under a microscope. So it's really important to understand how these PSA tests work and if one is at a higher risk of having prostate cancer due to family history, or if one is over the age of 50, it's important to talk to your primary care provider to see if having a PSA test done is right for you. And at Dane Garvin, we're committed to helping you better understand your health and being more aware so you can make informed health decisions.